بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to another session by My Maktab by the LMA with MLX Plus. We are doing Arabic for the Renisha book called Lughatul Islam. We have did four lessons before and we can always go back to them on YouTube and revise those lessons. The most important thing in Arabic is the vocabulary. Today we are moving on to the next lesson, and that is Ad-Darsul Khamis. Ad-Darsul Khamis. Ad-Darsul Khamis. Dars is lesson. Khamis, Khamsun, will be five. So we are busy with lesson five. The vocabulary here is very important. We are discussing animals. Today we are discussing animals, and the lesson's title is, as you see it here, Hayawanatun. 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 Repeat. Hayawanatun. Hayawanatun. Haywanun is a singular. Haywanun means animal. Haywanat is plural, animals. Haywanat. Haywanun, hayatun is life. So the root word is hayatun, which is life, and all animate objects, all animals, we are also part of the animal kingdom. We also have life, so we are hayyun. So hayawanatun, hayawanatun. Al hayawanatul bait, hayawanatul baiti, hayawanatul baiti, al bait. We call the Kaaba baitullah. Bait means house. So hayawanat, of the house, that means animals that live within the house, like a cat, like a dog, like birds. So these are what we call in English domestic animals. Domestic animals. Hayawanatul bait. Ad-darsul khamis. Hayawanatul bait. So the new word khamis is fifth. Hayawanatun is animals, and bait is house, but we'll translate it as domestic animals. So we have three words so far for today. One is al-khamis, number two is hayawanatun, and al-bait is three. Let's see which is the first animal we are going to be talking about. So repeat with me. Samakun, 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 samakun. Samakun is a new word which you are going to learn today, samakun. And if I use the word hada, which we learned in lesson two, was hada, this. So this is a fish. This is, and the word is in Arabic, we won't get the equivalent. This is hada samakun. So Arabic is more concise. Hada samakun. Together, hada samakun. Hada samakun. So the first of the domestic animals, hayawanatul bait, is samakun. And we have a samakun in a goldfish, or maybe in a tank, and we keep it in the house, and gives us a lot of pleasure to keep it, and we like to eat fish also. So hada samakun, hada samakun. The next word we learn here is al-ma. Al-ma'u, al-ma'u, al-ma'u. Okay, we got al-ma'u. Right, hada samakun. And a new word here is al-ma'u. So word number four was samakun. Word number five for today is al-ma'u. Let's make a sentence with al-ma'u. Let's make a sentence with al-ma'u. Okay, samakun, and you put the al, it still remains the same. As-samaku, well, means the fish. Samakun is fish. As-samaku will be the fish. And the new preposition which we did previously also, fi. I'm sure you remember the word fi, but let's just repeat it, is in. The word fi is in. And then we put our new word of today, al-ma'u. Al-ma'u. I'm sure we can translate it, as-samaku fil ma'i. As-samaku fil, because of the fi, we'll get the kasra. So hada samakun, as-samaku fil ma'i. Hada samakun, as-samaku fil ma'i. Have you got it? I'm sure we can translate it. As-samaku was fish, the fish in, the word is doesn't come in, and ma'un, we didn't give you the meaning, but we can't live without it. We need ma for our bathing, we need ma'un for our drinking, we need ma'un for our cooking, we need ma'u for wudu, we need ma'u for ghusl. So al-ma'u is water. Well, fish have to live in water. So as-samaku fil ma, the fish is in the water. Hada as-samakun as-samaku fil ma'i. Hada as-samakun as-samaku fil ma'i. And that brings us to the fifth word for today. So let's go through it again. Ad-darsul khamis, dars means lesson. Al-khamis was the fifth. Right? And the discussion here is hayawanatul bayt. We said animals, and bayt was house, so it becomes domestic animals. The first animal that we have, or mammal we have in our vocabulary today is samakun. And hada we did before, so hada samakun as-samaku fil ma'i. I think that's enough to digest for today. And the reference for this lessons are Lughat al-Islam by the Indonesia Muslim Association. Try and get yourself a copy. It'll make things easy for all of us. This is our lesson for today. We learned our five words. And inshallah, in our next lesson, we'll do further vocabulary. Jazakumullah. Wa alaikum as-salam.